this is the 40th year of the anniversary of the flag being installed. The flag was something that my dad wanted. It was, I think, a dream of his. He had been sheriff for probably just about a year, and he raised the money, and he really wanted it to be a tribute to the law enforcement officers and the firefighters in Jefferson Parish who put their lives at risk every day protecting our community.
The interesting thing about Sheriff Harry Lee is that he's a true patriot. He always looked for innovative ways to express his patriotism, you know, having served in the military. He was always very appreciative of all of the privileges that he enjoyed as a U.S. citizen, all the while still being very proud of his Chinese ethnic culture, but always really trying to express his appreciation for the privileges of being a U.S. citizen.
Sheriff Lee had a great love of the flag and of America. He said, "I'm thinking of doing something to honor the police and the firemen." And then he said, "And we don't have a big flag that can be seen by the public in this parish that I know of."
In typical Harry Lee fashion, he doesn't really grasp the enormity of the effort. So he got this idea of wanting to fly the biggest flag. He had seen a big flag, I think, on the North Shore, and he loved it every time we drove by it. And he'd always comment about it, and he'd say, I want to put up a big, big flag at Veterans and Causeway, bigger than that one."
My father was larger than life. I mean, he loved carnival, he loved hunting, he loved fishing, he loved eating, he loved children. You know, once he had this in his mind that he was gonna put this flag up, you knew it was gonna happen.
People were very generous. People were very interested in doing this. Manufab donated a lot of money. Many people, many business people in the community donated money. And B&G Crane was going to help with the logistics of setting up the pole.
I remember we ended up communicating with a company by the name of Betsy Ross Flag Company at some point in time. And they made a flag 30 by 50. So we began to look at the engineering behind what does it take to support a 30 by 50 flag. And man, were we surprised. I mean, you know, it wasn't as simple as digging a hole and sticking a pole in the ground, right? And this thing, I just vividly remember the complexity of it. And when we engaged an architect and an engineer to look at it with the wind load and this and that, we knew right away that it was going to be a significant undertaking. But in true Harry Lee fashion, he was not going to be deterred. In fact, he was probably more committed to the project than ever before.
You had to do underground footing to hold up something of that weight, and you had to really know a little bit engineering to be able to have a big flag up there that would take the wind and not destroy the pole.
Our responsibility is kind of twofold. We assist the parish in protecting that monument, not only the monuments at that square, but specifically the flag. Raising and lowering the flag, obviously, for bad weather events, but then also for tragic events around our country when the flag is lowered to half staff. Our community affairs department does a great job of trying to monitor that, whether it's hurricane season or just regular weather events, to make sure that flag can continue flying over Jefferson Parish and our community as it has for the last 40 years.
We planned a big dedication day on Flag Day, June 14th. We had all the sheriff's office people there in review and firemen in their full dress uniforms. And after the ceremonies, we had a big family picnic there on the neutral ground, a real American picnic with hot dogs. And then we went across the river and did the same thing on the West Bank.
I was at the celebration that day. I remember it well. And it was a big event. And, you know, to this day, that is something that we are always proud of. We know where the flag is, we see it, it's a part of our lives, and it's been there for decades.
You can always see that flag from afar. So it's a really iconic location for Jefferson Parish, and obviously the prosperity of Jefferson Parish because of the tax base in that area. But it's also something that we know is going to be flying for years to come.
Him being sheriff was really about him. That flag and the support for that flag was really more about the community. It was about something bigger than him.
I think as long as there are people alive to say his name, his legacy will never die, nor will anything that he ever did.
I'm sure he's looking down with a huge smile on his face. You know, that 40 years later, the flag is still up. And I think if there's ever a wish on his part, is that that flag would fly in perpetuity.
If you were to ask my dad, you know, what was one of the most important things he did, of course, he would have said decades of serving the people of Jefferson Parish and decades of trying to keep the people safe. But I think he would have been just so proud to know that that flag that he was just instrumental in bringing, and it was a dream of his to bring, still flies to this day.